So today's topic is creating some semi-automatized report in QGIS using data exported from SW maps. So let us try this one. So I have already exported the map as shown in this browser. So this is here exercise 06 GNSS. And this is GNSS practice GPKG, which is exported from SW maps. And this is the point data of road damage. So we drag and drop this, and we can see that this is plotted, but we don't know where it is. So we add one background layer. So we add this background layer, OpenStreetMap. So we need to double click, and it is shown here, and we keep it below the road damage point data. And now we'll prepare a report. So first of all, we will make a layout. So from layout manager, we create a layout report GNSS, and now we will add this map here. So in this GeoPackage file, we also have some photographs, so I keep some empty space here. And I make it 1000 so that more area is visible, so we can identify where the photo is taken. And now we make it atlas. So generate an atlas, and we will use the road damage with only layer, and page name will be changed based on this FID. And it will be sorted by time in case the FID is not serially saved. So time is maybe best one. And then we change this item property of this map to controlled by Atlas. So once we activate the Atlas, the map will be centered to the Atlas feature. So if we move this, the map will also move, and the second feature will be in the center. So we can see that, but we don't know just by changing the Atlas feature, but we need to change this symbol so that only the Atlas feature is shown. So I will show you how we do this. So double click this one and choose symbology. And in the symbology, first of all, we make it SVG marker. So let us make it SVG marker of size maybe about 50. So let us make it 50. So now we change this rule so that only the Atlas feature, which is shown in the Atlas, will be visible. So in the label, so we write photo spot, and filter we make it based on the ID, which if the ID of the feature is equal to the ID of the feature shown in the Atlas. So we write it Atlas feature ID. So if both are equal, then only it will show the symbol. So if we apply, and then we can see that only the symbol in the this which is in the atlas is shown. So we just click OK. Now if we refresh this one, we can see that it is shown in the center. So this way we can change the symbol, and now we add text to show the attributes of the this spot. So I have already prepared this attribute as table. If we copy this and paste here, then we can change it to HTML. So we can see that it is rendered as a table, but the value is XX. So we need to change this to expression. So this should be changed to the field name is road name, and similarly we change this to location. So this is changed. Similarly, we change this damage grade to also the location field values from damage grade. Okay. So now table is finished. So we can change the, once we change this atlas feature, the map as well as this table will change. So, but we need to put image here, which is stored in photo 1 and photo 2. For that, we add picture here. So, this picture, and we keep it as raster ID, and on the right side, we can see the variable which we can edit. And just if you remember the field, so we can just make it like this. And we have one more photo, so we can just copy and paste and then change this attribute to photo 2. Okay. So it works only for the geo package saved by SW maps. If we have a saved as save file, we have to refer to the field and we have to change the image source. So this saving as geo package has the advantage. And now we can see that image is also changing.